baseball fans, and welcome. We've got a perfect night for baseball on the show. It's the Boston Red Sox taking on the Seattle Mariners. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. Just about ready to roll. And on the mound today, Luis Castillo. How about a report on him, Chris?
Well, this is a guy that usually turns in a very good outing. People like playing behind him. Everyone seems to be loose, and the offense tends to get going. So, you know, you look at an opposing lineup, when they see him out there in the mound, they know that he's going to compete. They don't want to let him settle in. They want to try to knock him out, get into that bullpen before he gets real comfortable.
Tristan Casas at the plate now. That's ball one. The next pitch misses, and that's ball two. Swing and a miss. Luis Castillo, a guy who debuted in 2017 with the Reds at 24 years old, multiple All-Star appearances, traded to the Mariners at the deadline in 2022. You think about that triple-digit fastball, but the changeup is the thing that stands out.
Yeah, and you could argue that he's got the best changeup in baseball. From the right side, it's like a Bugs Bunny pitch and works so well off of his fastball.
3-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Now, pitchers have become so much better at commanding that high fastball. It used to be that a lot of guys didn't like to throw it because it threw off their release point and their mechanics, and they're aimed at keeping everything at the knees, get ground balls. But because hitters get a swing path that can lift balls at the knees up in the air and over the fence, this pitch has come back into play, and they are doing some special things with it.
No score, just getting started, top of the first. Next pitch is in the dirt, and it's a ball and a strike. Righty delivers. And Devers hits that one. And in one hops the wall.
With that fastball, even though it's high velocity, you've got to live on the outer edges. When it's right on a tee, right down the middle, professional hitters are not going to have a problem turning it around.
Here's Justin Turner. That one's in there, 0-1. Castillo, an All-Star a season ago, he features a four-seam fastball, a sinker, a changeup, and he works in a slider. The pitch. Hit on the ground, might be two. Over to Wong. And it's a double play to end the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, and no one left. So now the Mariners' offense gets to go to work for the first time. We've got no score. Back in Seattle, and starting this one, Chris Sale. Chris, what should we keep an eye on here with him?
Well, Sale's a strikeout pitcher, and the thing about it is he'll throw strikes early, but then start teasing the zones, and that's what the great ones do. You got to make sure you elevate him, get him out over the plate. That's the only way you're going to have a chance.
And stepping in for the Mariners, Colton Wong.
The second baseman.
Singing strikeouts are king these days, and entering the 2023 season, Chris Sale holds the big league record. He is the leader, most strikeouts per nine innings. Sale delivers.
One ball.
Well, one thing about Chris Sale is he's got such a devastating slider, and it doesn't matter if you're a left-hander or a right-hander. If you're a lefty, it's going away from you. If you're a righty, it's coming at that back right foot.
Sale ready. And now it's even up. And a swing and a line drive at a right field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one down. And now we check out the Mariners lineup. We could be in for a power showcase today with the wind blowing out a lot of lift and separate, Chris.
Well, we know guys are in this era definitely trying to hit the ball in the air regardless of the conditions, but I think even a little more so there's margin for error if you can get the ball up in the air. So, you know, you'll see at times, I'm sure, with two strikes, what looks like a half swing that can get out of the ballpark with a guy who's got decent pop.
Next offering upstairs. Got the bat going too soon. It's strike two. The next offering misses. Now 2-2. Way inside, gets out of the way. And Sale deals. Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, he should get some fist bumps when he gets back into the dugout, because even though he strikes out, he saw a lot of pitches and he battled. And this is a long haul where you're trying to get that pitch count up as early as possible. So gave the guys behind him an opportunity to see what's working for this pitcher or not. But I tell you what, it's a nice job right there.
Kicks and deals. And that one is lifted in the air. Duvall moving under this one and makes the play, and that's out number three. We'll head to inning number two at T-Mobile Park. No score. Back here at the ballpark, all set for the start of the inning. Now the left fielder, Alex Verdugo. Verdugo, former second round pick by the Dodgers back in 2014. And Chris, I think one of the things that people always focus on with him, he was the centerpiece to that Mookie Betts trade between the Dodgers and the Red Sox. Next pitch misses, ball two.
Yeah, and many people would say that's a ton of pressure to go into a place like Boston with those shoes to fill. And you know what? He went in there saying he was going to be himself and put up some pretty good numbers.
Next pitch is downstairs. And he walked him.
Definitely lost the handle during that sequence. Four pitches for the walk, and that last one didn't even threaten the zone. Catcher might want to go talk to him.
Here's Kike Hernandez. Rudder takes off. Now he breaks his bat. France puts it away, and there's one away. Throw behind the runner, and they've got him doubled off. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's the right fielder, Adam Duvall. The outfield playing him to pull, with the center fielder positioned in that left center field gap. And first offering is fouled off. In the air, right side. And that should be extra bases. And that's a double.
The catcher, Reese McGuire.
Here's Reese McGuire. First pitch, and he just misses.
Well, they're looking to get on the board first here after that clutch two-out double made this inning interesting.
Second inning here, no score. Swings and misses.
One more.
And a count even, 1-1. Next pitch is popped up. France sizes this one up. He's got it. And that is out number three. One hit, one left. Now to the bottom of the second. We're tied. Nothing, nothing. And welcome back. Bottom of the inning. Now, Teoscar Hernandez. Here comes a pitch. Upstairs. And there's a strike.
Well, it looks like he's wanting to work the upper part of the strike zone. What does that mean? Top hand better be working for the hitters. Adjust that side a little bit. Give yourself a chance to hit.
The pitch. And that's outside. The wind and the pitch.
Ball three. Two balls. One strike.
Fouls one away, and now 3-2.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. Hernandez racing over to make the catch.
Hey,
Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. This is another guy capable of hitting tape measure home runs. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high.
Next one misses. Now two balls and a strike.
One strike.
The big lefty turns, kicks, deals.
Full count.
Got him looking. That's a strikeout.
This guy will throw any pitch at any count. 3-2. He goes off speed, gets the out.
And now for Seattle, Cal Raleigh. And fouled off. And here it comes. And he grounds one to the right side. Sends it to first. And that is the inning. Offense held in check there. We played two full. We're tied. Nothing, nothing. Back at T-Mobile Park. New inning getting started. Now it's the shortstop, Yu Chang. And the pitch. Chang playing up the middle at short in the eighth spot in today's lineup, and he found his way onto the team after being claimed off waivers. Next offering misses, and that's ball two. There's a strike.
Cold night tonight, Boog, and that's a pretty firm fastball right there. I tell you what, memories of getting jammed, they are creeping into my mind right now.
Next pitch is inside. 3-1 now. And he pumps it a strike.
Full count.
And that one handled. Gets it to first. One up, one down.
Batting up. The second base.
Here's Christian Arroyo. Ground ball left side. Suarez picks it up, zips it across. Out. Two up, two down.
That's what a good sinker is designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
Now batting Tristan Casas. In there for strike one. Top of the third, no score. Next pitch is popped up. Suarez has this one sized up. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And that is that. Red Sox go down quietly and we're still knotted at zero. Back in Seattle, now it's the DH, A.J. Pollock.
The designated hitter,
A.J.
The pitch. There's a swing and a drive. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
He was all over that first pitch fastball. Just barely missed it. Man, this guy was ready to hit.
So digging in, Sam Haggerty, the switch hitter batting right. Next offering is down low. 1-0.
Go, Mariners.
That one missed.
That's the ball.
Just off the outside part of the plate. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
That just came apart right there. Four pitch walk, and guy at the plate was not going to help him out by swinging at something out of the zone.
One gone, runner at first. J.P. Crawford up next for the Mariners. Crawford, 28 years old, and he won a gold glove in the shortened 2020 season. On the ground, a second, might be two. There's one. On the first, double play, and that's the inning. Three up, three down that time. Three innings complete. We're tied. Nothing, nothing. Welcome back as we go to the top of the fourth. Now the third baseman, Rafael Devers. Castillo back to work. Chris, you ready for a nugget?
Ready.
Rafael Devers homered in three straight games against the Yankees before he turned 21. The only other player to do that, Babe Ruth.
Outside.
Next pitch off the play. And 1-1. Good eye right there. The next pitch misses, and the count is 3-1. Left-hand hitter waits. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted in first base with a quick free pass.
Here's Turner now. 0-1 so far. First pitch, not close. Devers on at first. Nobody out. And the right-hander deals. Going to count one and two. The pitch. Struck him out without a swing. Fastball at the letters, frozen for strike three.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
Here's Alex Verdugo. Worked a walk in his first trip to the plate. Maybe a two ball. Five, four, three. It's a double play, and that'll do it for the inning. Three up, three down for him there. We're midway in the fourth. We're tied, nothing, nothing. Back here at the ballpark, John Chabi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Colt Muong. The wind of the pitch. And first offering is fouled off. And a pitch. And a foul ball. The wind to kick the pitch. Bounce to the right. Casas picks it up. He handles it himself. One out in the bottom of the fourth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Julio Rodriguez up next for the Mariners. 0 for 1. He struck out swinging last time. In there, and it's 0-1. And that one almost got him. And he deals. And 1-2.
1-2.
Just missed.
It's a good take.
Next offering down in the dirt.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. The Mariners still looking for their first hit in this one. Left field, way back there. This one's got a chance. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. That's what the fans came to see. The Mariners strike first. It's 1-0.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
So one out, nobody on. Ty France up next for the Mariners. And that's in there for strike one. Kicks and fires. Off the mark there. And that's ball one.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
And now the lefty. And a count one and two. The wind of the pitch. The punch out there. And how about Chris Sale locked in now?
Well, he froze him with a great fastball right on the corner. It's kind of like bowling when you think the ball's going to get into the gutter and somehow just hangs onto that edge and knocks down a pin. Well, he got the outside corner of the plate and got that called third strike.
Hernandez in the box now. No balls and a strike.
Well, he's been incredibly efficient in this one. First pitch strike percentage over 70%. That's well above league average, and that's what's allowed him to pitch well up until this point.
Two down, nobody on. Swing and a miss. And the count is one and two.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Teoscar Hernandez hits one out, and they add to the lead. It's 2-0.
A breaking ball on the inside part of the plate requires a hitter to stay really square with his mechanics. If you fly open with the front shoulder, there's no way you keep that ball fair. An outstanding job mechanically. He deserves that home run.
Base is empty with two away. Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. First offering misses the mark. A swing and a miss, and that's strike one. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. Hernandez has it sized up. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. And it's 2-0. We go to the top of the fifth. Here's the center fielder, Enrique Hernandez.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
The right-hander back to work. That catches the zone for a strike. That's strike one.
Well, the offense has gotten going, and a pitcher wants to go out there, have a real quick inning, get those guys back into the dugout so those bats can stay hot.
Righty to the plate. Swings through that. Got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it.
Well, that's not the best two-strike fastball I've seen, but it certainly got away with the location there. You know, sometimes as a hitter, when you're down in the count, you're so focused on a pitcher painting the black, and you just get a little bit locked up on something down the heart of the plate, not expecting it, and it just kind of freezes you.
Duvall in the box with one away as he takes ball one. Next pitch misses inside. Two balls, no strikes. Right-hander kicks, deals. The other way, and he beats the shift.
Wasting no time. He's two for two now on the night and just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. Man at first with one gone, and here's the catcher, Reese McGuire. And the first offering is not close. Duvall leads off first with one away. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
The next offering misses, and it's 2-1. Tying run at the plate. Runner takes off. Swing and a miss. The throw, tag, and he's out.
Not a fast runner on the base path, so this kind of looks like it was a hit and run called from the dugout. Got to make contact some way or somehow, because that guy's not going to be able to steal second base and be safe.
Two two now. Kicks his swing. Appeal down to third. And he couldn't hold back. He's rung up on strikes. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now the Mariners catcher, Cal Raleigh. And Chris, his big strength is defense. But it is interesting, in today's world of baseball compared to when you played, a good defensive catcher is considered differently.
Whatever you get offensively is a bonus, but he's got to put the fingers down. He's got to present pitches to the umpire. They're going to help his pitcher get more strikes.
The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. I think the other component is putting down the finger that the pitcher wants to throw and being on the same page, and that's something that this guy does really well, gets in sync with his pitchers. That misses the zone, and now 3-1.
Boog, his preparation is off the charts. I was down in the clubhouse today trying to find him just to pick his brain a little bit. He's so buried in that video room, it's hard to get a chance to talk to him.
Arroyo makes the grab, and there's one down. AJ Pollock at the dish. Flied out his first time. First offering misses badly for ball one. Tap dances out of the way of that one. And he hits a ground ball right side, and foul ball. Next pitch misses, and it's a full count. And there's ball four.
The bat.
Now don't here is it. Sam Haggerty. That one out to right. Duvall drifts towards it. Drops into the glove, two away down.
Now batting, shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
J.P. Crawford gets a chance to hit. He hit into a double play his first time up. First That's pitch doesn't find the zone. Left-hand batter waits. And a swing and a miss there.
Kelly just threw that fastball by him, elevated. And if you're not looking up in that location, very difficult to catch up to, especially with that velocity.
sailing a 1-2. Got him looking for the strikeout. Called strike three on a fastball up in the zone. Mariners leave one, but they're on top 2-0. Back at T-Mobile Park, all set for the top of the sixth. And the batter will be the shortstop, Yu Chang. Castillo back to work. And there's the strike. Now the 0-1. And ball one. Next offering is in for a strike. Righty delivers. And now 2-2. Pitch misses there, and the count's full.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff walk.
Got it by him for the K.
Now batter.
The batter now, Christian Arroyo.
Arroyo.
That hits the dirt, and that's ball one.
That pitch wasn't even close, and they still got a check swing out of it. He's going to have to make an adjustment and make it fast.
Next one misses, and the count is 2-0.
Pitch.
Swings through that one out in front that time. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
In the air, out towards left center. Rodriguez racing over to make the catch.
Now that the first
Tristan Casas Tristan up next for the Red Sox. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
One ball, one strike.
Next offering is in for a strike. Cut on and miss, struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field.
And welcome back. Now it's the second baseman, Colton Wong.
The second baseman.
Wong goes 5 feet 7 inches, 32 years old, and he's a former National League Gold Glover. That's a strike. That's strike one. Line drive. That's a base hit out of the left center field. Now he'll turn for second. And he starts the bottom of the sixth with a double.
All over that one right there. That ball was drilled 106 off the bat, and that's the kind of feedback that tells you you're right where you want to be with your swing mechanics.
And up next for Seattle, Julio Rodriguez. Outfield deep here, trying to prevent anything over their heads. And a foul ball.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
0-1 down. Good eye in that spot. Boston's bullpen with some activity. Tanner Houck preparing to come on if needed. Brazier getting cranked up as well. And a pitch. Squirts away a little bit. No advance. Good job behind the dish. Next offering upstairs. No outs. Runner on second. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away.
No, Boog, I'll tell you, when he goes to look at the video of that pitch, he's going to want to punch himself. That slider had hit me ridden all over it, and clearly he just got a little too excited and was out in front. Tell you what, when you get a pitch like that, you cannot miss it. Those have a chance to go a long way.
France in the box again, takes a strike. That misses one the more. Zone. Ball one. And a good eye there. Runner at second here, one gone. Next pitch way upstairs.
Good pitchers make pitches in big situations. And right here with the middle of the order hitter up, runner in scoring position, he's got to find a way to throw a quality strike.
At the belt and fires. And strike two. And ball four, two aboard.
Well, he took his chance at getting him to chase right there, but with first base open, walked out a bad thing. He set up a double play opportunity if he can induce a ground ball.
And now Teoscar Hernandez. Well struck right field. Duvall going back on this one. Still going back. And brings it in at the wall. So first and second with two outs. And here is Eugenio Suarez. Lots of pop at the plate. Outfield playing back almost on the warning track. That one's in there 0-1.
If he can get through this one, put up a zero, this will help in his outings to come.
Close one, doesn't get the call. And that is ball one. First and second, two down. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, this is a higher leverage spot, and I love the way that he's turned things around. He's got two outs now ahead in this count, and he can pretty much dictate what's going to happen next in terms of the pitch sequence.
1-2 now. Sail back to work.
No.
And that's outside.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Got him swinging. Pulled the string on the changeup. Mariners leave a couple as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Back in Seattle, top of inning number 7. Now the number 2 hitter, Rafael Devers.
The third baseman, Rafael.
The pitch.
Devers.
Fly ball, pretty well struck right field. Way back there. And out of here. Rafael Devers rounds the bases. And they're on the scoreboard. It's 2-1. He sent the first pitch over the wall.
Must have dinner reservations because he wasn't wasting any time at the plate in that at bat. Power versus power right there, like two locomotives colliding. Who's going to win? But a really good job there by the hitter getting the top hand working. Powers that fastball out of here.
Justin Turner now. In there for strike one.
Folks, just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
Next offering is in for a strike.
All right, now, he may have not liked either of those first two pitches or agreed with the umpire's calls, but at this point, he's going to have to bear down and be ready to hit anything close to the zone.
1-2.
Next pitch in the dirt. Now 1-2.
0-2 fastball way out of the zone. I think he's trying to speed him up. Got to stay back. Off speed's probably coming.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Some high cheese for strike three.
Not the best location with the fastball on strike three, but when you're pumping high 90s, you'll get away with some of those. More margin for error. You know, the fastball has become such a huge strikeout pitch in the sport, and I think a lot of it has to do with all the attention and emphasis on improved spin rates. These fastballs are just exploding out of the pitcher's hands and jumping through the zone.
Verdugo now at the plate as he swings through strike one. Pitch misses inside, and it's 1-1. Inside, just missed. Next offering misses. Now 3-1.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
And that's ball four.
Well, he's starting to look a little gassed to me, and we'll see if they go to the bullpen in this spot or not.
And here comes Scott Servais as he's ready to make a change on the mound. Luis Castillo won't go any further, and he was a tough nut to crack. Pretty stingy from start to finish. Back with the new arm after a quick break. Penn Murphy gets handed the rock out of the pen.
Number 56.
And now the center fielder, Enrique Hernandez. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
And a big swing and a miss. Next one is off the plate, and it's 2-1. One run game, one out, one on. Runner on the go, grips one to right, down the line, and it's foul. Two two now.
Well, in this count, runner. Not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Bert.
Maybe a two ball. 5-4-3 double play. And the inning is over. But not before they answer back with a solo home run. And this is now a 2-1 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Welcome back. Set for the last half of the seventh. And now it's going to be Cal Raleigh. The pitch. That one misses, and it's 1-0.
One ball, no strike.
Swing and a miss, strike one. Kicks and deals. And that one fouled off. And Sale ties him up that time, gets the strikeouts. One of the things Chris Sale likes to do, get inside on the righties. No messing around with the pitch calling in that sequence right there. Four pitches, all fastballs.
Yeah, and that makes me think that was the plan before the at-bat even started. If you think you can simply just beat a guy with only your fastball, why throw him anything else until he shows you he can handle it?
Next to hit, A.J. Pollock. First pitch, not close. And there's a ball.
2-0 to count.
On the ground, right side. Arroyo whips it to first. And they take care of Pollock for the out.
The left fielder.
And stepping in for the Mariners, Sam Haggerty.
Now just about to hit that century mark, 100 pitches for this game.
And the first offering is not close. And a swing and a miss. One one now. And that one fouled off. The next pitch misses. It's 2-2. And another ball. Chris Sale looking for that shutdown inning. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Pulled the string on the changeup. And 1-2-3 go the Mariners as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Back here at the ballpark, Adam Duvall at the plate.
A lot of times you're looking for a guy to get that tying run on base, but because of the power, you want him to tie up the game with one swing here.
And here it comes. Good eye right there. Action in the bullpen for Seattle. Paul Sewald, the closer, getting cranked up for a possible save opportunity. The tying run at the plate. And that's in there at the knees. And a 1-1. That one in there across the letters.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Liner caught it second. New pitcher for the Mariners, Andres Munoz. He's into the game with the bases empty.
Number 75, Andres Munoz.
So stepping in for Boston, Reese McGuire. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. First offering misses badly for ball one. One down, base is empty. gets the outside corner with that one. Inside corner for a strike. It's a ball and two strikes. And the righty deals. And now the count filled up 3-2. Registers the punch out and hits 101. So the bullpen doing a nice job backing up the effort from their starter.
Yeah, we've seen some pretty excellent pitching out of this staff so far. I mean, they've come in ready to do their job and get outs. They've been pretty tough to get to in this one.
Digging in, Yu Chang. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. And that's in there for strike one. And a pitch. Swing and a miss as he was out front.
Very solid inning on the mound so far here in the eighth. Holding on to this narrow lead. This is exactly what they were looking for.
Rips that one to right. And that's the inning. Down in order go the Red Sox. And our score remains 2-1. Pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Richard Bleier.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their guys a chance to fight back into the game.
Well, one run game, and now the shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
J.P. Crawford.
The pitch. On the ground to short, Chang collects it. Not in time, he legs it out.
It doesn't really matter where you are in the lineup. Your job is to get on base and try to start a rally if you're leading off an inning. So an infield single does the job right there. Now we'll see if they can make something happen.
Colton Wong up to hit for the fourth time tonight. Puts a bunt down. Casas tosses to the pitcher covering the bag as the pitcher brings it in for the out and the runner advances to second.
Number 34, Julio.
So up next, Julio Rodriguez. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. He is quite an athlete. I mean, you look around the other sports, basketball, football, you feel like he could thrive in one of those sports too. In there, and it's 0-1.
Really good cutter that he's able to front door and back door. That pitch is devastating.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
He's clearly out there throwing pitcher's pitches in this situation. First base is open. If he walks him, no big deal.
Here's the 0-2. One out and a runner at second.
Whoa, let's get some runs here.
Next ball pitch one. Misses. Now 1-2.
One ball, two strikes.
Fastball, and he gets out of the way. The 2-2. He goes down looking.
Third time he struck out in this one, and definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead and getting that W.
And now here is Ty France. And a foul ball. 0-1 now. And that one in the air center field. Hernandez makes the catch, and that'll do it. One left for Seattle, but they still lead it 2-1. Paul Sewald on a pitch out of the pen here.
Number 37, Paul.
Well, one run game, and here is Christian Arroyo. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. Here comes a pitch. That's ripped into the outfield. And there's one away.
Man, that's so frustrating. You hit the ball hard, you understand the situation, you want to get on base and try to score that tying run, but no reward right there, and just going to have to sit on it.
Casas swings through it for strike one. Chew now. Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout.
It came out of his mechanics there. Typically, he likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Rafael Devers up to hit. The outfield shifted pretty heavily towards right field. First offering, and it just misses. Sewald, 32 years old, and he was a 10th round pick back in 2012. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. And it's fouled away. One and two. Right-handed reliever fights that one away. Still one and two. Two outs. Fouls it off. Still one and two.
You could see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
Gets a piece and stays alive. And a 1-2 again. Fights it off, you'll see another. One and two here. Got him! And that's the ball game.
The way pitcher's doing in this one, you get to a certain point where each pitcher is trying to outdo the other, go a little bit deeper into the ball game. And for these guys, it really came down to a few key at-bats. This was a fun one to watch.
And your final score here today, 2-1. They hang on to win it by a run. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
our final line score. First for the victorious Seattle Mariners. Two runs on four hits, no errors. They left five men on base. For the Red Sox, one run.